and gentlemen, it's Late Night Chicago with your host, Mason Manna. Tonight's co-host, Jenna Baroni. From Ambassador Talent, Susan Sherman. With special appearances by Edward Dennis Fogel and Roberta Gennaro. And here's your host, Mason Manna!
Hey! Hey, you guys. Hey, everyone. Welcome to Late Night Chicago. I'm your host, Mason Manna. So thrilled to have you with us here tonight. We have a great show lined up for you tonight. We have Susan Sherman from Ambassador Talent. She's in the house tonight, and we're going to pick her brain for all the information that we can. So stick around for all the actors and models that are looking to get into the entertainment industry. We have a great agent that's going to talk with us here at Late Night Chicago. So without any further ado, I do want to introduce you to my beautiful co-host this evening, Miss Jenna Baroni. Everyone give her a warm welcome, please.
Hey, Jenna.
Hi.
How are you?
I'm good.
Good.
How are you?
Great. Have a seat.
Thank you.
Oh, right. You look fantastic.
Thank you. You too.
Oh, well, thank you. How are you?
I'm pretty good. How are you?
I am.
How's everything going?
Fantastic. Thank
nice.
You. Thank you very much. Thank you for being here tonight.
Yeah. Thank you for inviting me.
Absolutely. It's my pleasure. So, Jenna, I do want to introduce you to our audience.
Sure.
Now, I heard there's a little rumor that you were actually born or you lived on a pirate ship, right?
That's funny. Well, I was born and raised in the Republic of Moldova, which is a small and beautiful country nestled between Ukraine and Romania, Eastern Europe.
Awesome. Wonderful. Yeah. That's really cool. How long did you live in Moldova for?
19 years.
Oh, so the majority of your life.
Yeah, I was born and raised there.
Born and raised in Moldova, and then you came to Chicago how long ago now?
2 years from now, yeah.
Wow,
time is flying. I can't believe that myself.
That is really cool. So, and what was Chicago the first time you were in America?
Well, yes.
So you just came straight from Moldova,
yes,
crossed the ocean,
you know, I
came to Chicago.
You know, acting, music, and dancing has been my dream for as long as I can remember, my passion, and I came to this country because I wanted to follow and live my dream as an actress, model, dancer, musician.
Absolutely, yeah. Now, I do know that you have a beautiful singing voice.
I've heard
you sing before.
Thank you.
And you really, really do. Very, very talented.
I heard there was a secret chord that David played and pleased the Lord. You don't really care for music, do ya? Well, it goes like this: the fourth, the fifth, the minor fall, and the major lifts. Powerful King composing hallelujah, hallelujah,
I actually want to bring you on, one of these days we'll get you on the show, and I want everyone out there to hear her sing, because it's really, really awesome.
Okay,
and she plays the violin.
And, yeah, sure. I play violin.
Yeah.
I played violin for 7 years in my country. And
That's
then
so awesome.
Recently I started to play piano, and I find it very beautiful and just so amazing. When I want to just relax, I just sit and play piano. Really?
Wow.
Yeah.
So you definitely have a knack for music then. You're musically
absolutely
gifted.
Yes.
Now, I assume you obviously can read music. Do you write and compose music also?
You know, I actually wanted to. I want to start writing my own song.
Awesome.
And that takes a lot of work, first of all.
Absolutely.
But, yeah.
Well, let me know if you do, because we'll test it out here. You know?
Yeah.
Bring it on the show.
Sure.
We'll...
I would like to.
So you've been in America now 2 years.
Mm-hmm.
What is your favorite thing? I know you're a student here at the Chicago Actors Studio.
Sure.
What is your favorite thing so far that you've been involved with here in the studio?
people.
The people friends. Here?
Yes.
Yeah, definitely. It's a good crew around here.
Because, you know, I was looking for an acting studio when I got here. Mm-hmm. And I was looking for weeks. I found different acting studios, but I was looking for a good one, the mm-hmm. best in Chicago, and here I am.
You found it.
Chicago Actors Studio, yes. And I can say that these people are like a family for me. And when I come here, I feel like I'm coming home, you know?
Yeah.
And, you know, there is...
Absolutely.
Nowhere is better than home.
Exactly. Yeah, so yeah. I'm glad that helps make sure. the transition. Because I'm sure, you know, coming over to a new country, that's not an easy thing to do. That's
it's
really
not.
Risky.
So it is.
That's really awesome that you took that leap, but it's also really awesome that you have some solace here at the studio.
I'm very happy because I got to have you guys as my friends, and I could say my best friend, Edward Dennis Fogel, our artistic director and producer.
I'm sorry to hear
He's
that.
He's an amazing person.
Yeah. Well,
I don't know, anytime when I want to talk about him, I feel like I would cry, I don't know. I'm just so glad and lucky to yeah. have you guys close to me.
Absolutely. Yeah. Well, we are just as lucky. We feel real fortunate. So I'm really excited to see what you do next and how you progress
sure.
as an artist.
Thank you.
Yeah.
Thank
so,
you.
So again, thank you for being here tonight. And we have a great guest here, Miss Susan Sherman from Ambassador Talent. So we're going to take a quick break, and we'll be right back and bring Susan on out. So stick around, folks. Don't go anywhere. Chicago, thank you so much for being here with us tonight. Without any further ado, I'm going to bring out our guest of the evening, Miss Susan Sherman from Ambassador Talent. Everyone, please give her a very warm welcome. Susan, how are you?
Nice to see you.
Well, Susan, thank you so much for being here. We are thrilled to have you.
Oh, my pleasure. Glad to be here.
I'm glad to see you here.
Yes.
Wonderful.
Really, really great to have you. We really appreciate it.
Well, Ed Dennis is doing such a wonderful job with this incredible acting establishment, and it's my pleasure to be here.
Yeah.
Definitely.
Yeah. Thank you. Thank you.
Thank
it is
you.
A lot of fun here at the Chicago Actors Studio, that's for sure.
Yeah, it is.
So Susan, I do want to jump right into it. I know that you started off actually as an actor and a model.
When I was 16.
Wow.
I did as a model and an actor.
So just a couple years ago.
Exactly. Yeah. But what happened was I felt that a lot of my agents weren't representing me in the best way. And I thought, well, I think I can do better. Mm-hmm. And then I would start a relationship with one of the agents at the agency. And then I was working all the time and doing all these great bookings. And then I'd call to check in one day, and all of a sudden, they were no longer working there. And no
wow.
one told me why or anything.
Oh
they
God.
Just weren't there. And then you have to start all over again
right.
with a new
yeah,
agent and build
true.
The rapport again so they keep sending you out. So yeah. that's why I love what we have going in Ambassador Talent, because our agents have been with us for years. Mm-hmm. Ed has been with me for, gosh, many
right.
years. John has been with me a long time, Robert. So I love the stability, and I thought, I'm going to be an agent and I'm going to do it right. And it
nice.
Really has worked out well for us to have the relationship with our actors. So many of the actors mm-hmm. say, I walk into my agency and I get lost. I don't think mm-hmm. they even know who I am.
Right.
Well,
right.
that doesn't happen
yeah.
with us, because you can't represent someone effectively unless you have a real relationship.
That's
so
true.
That's yeah. what we pride ourselves mm-hmm. in.
Absolutely.
Sure do.
Well, that's awesome.
You are my agent as well, and I'm very happy to be represented by you. And they treat people with kindness and respect. I really like them. They're like my family.
Well, you're so beautiful and you're so talented, and
you
can act and you can sing. Your voice
you.
Is amazing. and yeah. you're working on your accent, which will also be That's helpful true. For some of the assignments to have the mm-hmm. accent. Because right. yeah. we have many international projects now as well, so mm-hmm. that will work. But you yeah. also are working on your American accent in a wonderful way, too,
yes,
with some of
I
the
do.
Techniques taught here at the school. So I'm right. so happy to see mm-hmm. that as well.
Yeah,
Thank
Jenna's
you.
Like a quadruple threat. Like,
she really is.
Thank you.
She can do it all.
Right.
I'm convinced of that.
Wow, thank you guys. I appreciate that.
So for all of our actors out there that are aspiring to get into the business, what is the first thing that you notice when someone submits to you? What is the first thing that you look for, or the first thing that you would notice that would have you toss them out as a potential candidate?
Well, first of all, it's the quality of the picture. I mean, it really is not that involved to get into the business any more these days. I mean,
right.
you used to have, I mean, I remember
right.
Years ago having to call Actors Weekly, we need more pictures, bring by 20 more. So they pay a fortune for their photo shoot, and then mm-hmm. they pay a fortune to have pictures run off constantly.
Right.
Because
yeah.
back in those days, we had filing cabinets. It wasn't all digital.
It
was
mail.
Very
yes.
cumbersome.
Yeah.
We had the courier coming multiple times a day,
right.
and then the client would change their mind. Oh, have the courier come back. We need this and this and this to add to it. It's like, great. But no, we first of all, we look for quality pictures, and mm-hmm. it's not that difficult or that expensive any longer to get really strong quality pictures.
Right.
And
mm-hmm.
that's first and foremost. And then the person has to decide what they want to do. Or do they want to do commercial print? Or are they an actor? And then their pictures mm-hmm. corresponding. Which
yeah.
For each of those disciplines, you know, your commercial
right.
smiling shot, which mm-hmm. will not transfer if you're an actor, because then you need a non-smiling theatrical shot.
More serious.
And very, very distinct differences. And so you need to be educated with what your interests are so that we can understand what you're trying to do to see if you might be a fit for us.
Right. Mm-hmm. So having a real deep understanding of how you're marketing and branding yourself as an artist and making sure that translates in the shots that you'll get and that you show to
Absolutely.
A potential agent.
Absolutely. Everyone should do research.
And yes.
and Chicago really needs to step up their game as well, because we receive emails and phone calls from casting directors that some of the actors we send are not us, from other agencies, never
but,
from us, no
but,
really,
well,
but are yes. not as disciplined as, say, an LA actor.
Right.
Where LA actors mm-hmm. are always off book, always prepared. An LA actor will give up their day job just for an audition.
Right.
That
yeah.
doesn't happen in Chicago.
Right.
People are very, mm-hmm. I wouldn't say the majority, but a lot of talent tend to be very laissez-faire. Here,
sure.
very casual
right.
about the business here. And you can't do that. We're competing with New York and LA
yes.
for the larger commercials.
Right.
I mean, we send actors worldwide now,
all amazing.
Over.
Right.
That's amazing.
And you have to be at the absolute top of your game with the best pictures. And if you're an actor, to have your clips posted online, not a mm-hmm. reel,
right.
but a 30 to 60 second clip.
Yes.
And just have. Start doing independent films. I mean, anything you can possibly do to step up your game.
Right, mm-hmm. absolutely.
If an actor auditions for you for being represented and they don't do a very good job, I mean, like, how long would you be expecting them to see them again? Or
well,
really?
We generally say about 6 months.
Okay.
It depends on how much work they
like
need to do.
Until they get better, right?
Right.
Yeah.
So we'll meet with them,
okay.
and sometimes it might be only 3 months.
Mm-hmm.
Or
mm-hmm.
if we see that there's a lot more work that needs to be done, we'll say 6. So it just depends on the individual.
Okay.
There's no cookie cutter formula as far as how long we tell them to work more on their craft and then check back in with us. But
right.
if we're interested in someone, we do give them a timeline. And then say,
okay.
you know, check back
yes.
with us at a later date with a recommended period of time.
That's good to know.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
yeah.
Now, actors definitely are an interesting bunch, majority of the time. do you have any outrageous stories or anything that really sticks out in your
well,
years?
Well, we have very anything? Interesting talent. We represent a talent canhead who is in the he's in the Guinness Book of World Records. He has the record for the most number of cans that stick to his head. I have sent him to Paris, Germany, Italy, Beijing.
Wow.
For all these documentaries. And I mean, he's incredible.
So there's a market like for cans.
He is a human suction cup.
I also
he also was cast on Chicago Fire as
with the cans?
Yes, as no.
Oh, okay.
No, but he was cast as the landlord for one of the actors.
Okay.
Who was being evicted, but so I have some interesting actors. Okay. Yes.
So like an aluminum can?
Really anything sticks to him. Like he can't wear a wetsuit, he would suffocate.
Huh.
He can never wear long pants, he wears shorts even in the winter, because his body, he's one of only three individuals in the entire world.
No kidding.
You should have him on sometime.
He is
fascinating.
We need to bring this guy
He is so great on camera.
Yeah.
He'll just like talk and talk. He's just fantastic.
Awesome.
But his body temperature is, I think, a degree higher than most human beings, any other human being. So that makes him. I guess he was at a ball game with his dad, a baseball game, and he was reaching back something to catch a ball. And he's like, where's the can? And it's like, it had stuck to his head. And then he realized he had that ability. But no, they either send him to every country or every country comes here to film him. It's pretty amazing.
Wow. That is fascinating. I had no idea.
You should have him on sometime. He's a really cool guy.
Yeah, let's talk after the show. I want to get
Absolutely.
His information. It's really great.
And I mean, there are all kinds of interesting people. I mean, stunt guys. I mean, we did a feature in South Korea for 3 months last fall and a big action feature. And we have a Vietnamese actor who's really tall and wide and big and intimidating. And he was there for 3 months working those stunts. And it's going to be released later this year. It's going
to
be amazing.
It's pretty hard to be a stunt.
It's just becoming so international.
Right.
I mean, we did a film in Lithuania last year, South Korea, Prague has become the Hollywood of Europe, so we send actors there for commercials.
Really, Prague?
Nice.
Prague.
Interesting.
Become quite the center for filming.
That is so interesting. It's really, really compelling how the market just evolves and
constantly
morphs.
Constantly.
Yeah.
And I mean, you can't even keep track of media anymore these days.
Oh,
you have
to
lump it all into new media because who knows what's going to turn up next to watch.
Exactly.
So many channels.
I mean, who
so many
knows?
Subjects.
It's so incredibly dynamic and how it's just constantly evolving.
Right.
It's really fascinating.
Absolutely.
It's like, what'll they come up with next?
Now, you work so hard, Susan, and you work so hard for your talent. And that is really inspiring.
It.
And that's great. Now, I do know, Ed told me that to wind down, you really enjoy horseback riding.
Oh, yes.
Right?
I have a beautiful Friesian, and it's one of the oldest horse breeds in the world. It's the ones that used to carry the knights and the carriages and all, but mostly the knights because they're such a big breed. And she's a sweetheart, and I get to see her about 3 times a week. She's in a really good home where she can walk out of her stall outside too, when she's out all day. But then she can walk outside of her stall too in her little run out, and she's just precious.
That's awesome.
I gave her carrots and apples the other day. She kissed me on the cheek.
Oh my God.
She's really sweet.
I want to see her.
She's precious.
Horses really are majestic creatures.
They're so beautiful.
They have just an energy to them that's just really unique. I had the pleasure actually of horseback riding over the summer.
Wonderful. Where were you?
I was in Wisconsin, actually, in the Dells.
Okay.
Of all places. And there was a horseback riding, and I went.
Did you enjoy it?
I loved it.
That's great.
Yes.
I actually loved it.
Ridden a horse. I want to.
Did you groom your horse, too? Do they let you do that?
They let me brush it and kind of bond with it for a second.
Cool.
And then I just hopped right on. And honestly, it was more natural than I thought it would be. To
to tug on the reins.
It's a relationship.
Yeah, it was really, really cool.
The more you ride, the less you have to tug on the reins.
She knows what it takes. Yeah.
You know, because, and I've actually gotten a deeper connection to the horse energy, I would say, recently, because I'm actually at the Actors Studio here studying a scene from Equus.
Oh, gosh, that's intense.
It is really intense, but I have the pleasure of a really awesome scene partner, and it is an intense show, but the reverence for horses, I mean, minus the tragedy, but the reverence up into that is, it's definitely something special.
It is.
Very nice, yeah.
It's something I've enjoyed. I've been riding since pre-kindergarten.
Yeah.
So I really enjoy it. I love the relationship.
Since then?
So my mom put me on a horse in pre-kindergarten, and that was it.
Lovely.
Ever since.
Your whole life, then,
essentially. Yes.
That's awesome.
It's beautiful.
That really is.
I want to see her, really.
You'll have to come out sometime.
I would like to.
And is it?
Ed came out to ride once.
Oh, really?
And he was brushing the horse and riding, and I was
awesome.
Watching him,
great.
And it was nice.
Where's the stable?
Yeah.
Oh, it's 65 miles away from the city.
And you go there 3 times a week to see
her? Before work on Wednesdays, too.
Wow. Wow.
I ride her 3 times a week, and then I have her ridden one other time.
That is really great.
And I take lessons regularly, too. I have a wonderful trainer whose mentor was the chief writer with the Spanish writing school in Vienna. So she's her very, very fine points of very detailed.
Yeah.
I mean, what I do is pretty much... like the compulsories in ice skating. It's like, it's very like precise.
Sure.
It's like,
yeah,
it's not.
And you have to know the technique. You can't
exactly.
Just.
Exactly.
So have you tried dressage or anything?
That's what I do.
You do dressage?
That's what I do.
That's cool.
That's why he was at the Spanish writing school in Vienna. So
yeah.
That's cool.
That's really cool.
And that's who she tutored under, so.
That's really awesome. Well, I may want to take you up on that because I really do love horses, and I would love to see that. I've never seen it. You said it was a Friesian?
Friesian.
Friesian breed. I've never
seen
one. She's
actually half Friesian, half Welsh cob. Her dad was a big, gorgeous Friesian, and she was kind of a happy accident.
That's awesome. That's awesome.
But she looks like a smaller, full-bred Friesian.
Right.
She's beautiful.
Right. Now, I do want to get back to a point that you said earlier, that Chicago, really the artists in Chicago, do need to step up their game
big time.
And especially because the market here in Chicago is growing. We have a lot of series and a lot of movies that are coming out to Chicago that are being produced out here. Can you tell us a little bit about the series that are in Chicago right now?
Well, we book regularly on Chicago Fire, Chicago PD, Chicago Med, Empire. There's a movie coming up. I saw a billboard on the way here, Rampage. There were 2 leads booked last summer. We had one of them. And then we just booked the pilot, Red Line.
Oh,
it's kind of a gritty Chicago story. And then we just booked another one, an untitled pilot, forgive me, I can't remember the name, but... but we just booked another one, and then it's been booking a lot in LA,
busy.
And we just did Dying Up Here on on Showtime and Animal Kingdom on TNT or vice versa.
Mm-hmm.
So it's busy.
Yeah, really busy.
Well, I remember when you sent me for Quicken Loans, I heard that you worked pretty hard on that, like booking 100 people in just 24 hours. That's amazing.
Oh, well, that became very demanding.
Wow.
Quicken originally was going to book a big Coliseum in Detroit. And they decided to come to Chicago, and they paid a lot more coming here.
Mm-hmm.
But they knew they could get the best talent here, and it was for March Madness.
Oh,
and
nice.
It was so much fun.
We had a great time.
They needed like 100 people a day, and a lot of them were featured, and it was a good time, and cheering, and mascots, and cheerleaders, and referees, and coaches.
We had a beautiful time,
And I mean, you do the commercials, you're fed very well, there's always wonderful food, you're always well taken care of.
meet new people.
But when you go even on a commercial audition, an actor needs to do research.
Mm-hmm. Yes, absolutely.
About the product, about their philosophy. Mm-hmm. You can't just go without being familiar with what you're auditioning for. You think, oh, it's just a commercial, oh, big deal.
Yeah.
We have actors who live on their residuals from commercials because the commercials are so successful.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
And I mean, there's a lot of money at stake.
Exactly.
And it's your reputation. Do you want a reputation as just a casual person who doesn't really have the focus that's necessary? Or do you want to have the best reputation, mm-hmm. knowing that casting is going to call you in each and every time because they know they can count on you for a good audition? I mean, the email that we received from a major casting company mm-hmm. just this morning said, we don't have the time to keep rehearsing and rehearsing with the script till they get the audition right.
Yes. Right.
We need to know, get them on their mark and do the audition. We may want to have an adjustment and have them do it another way.
Right.
But we expect you to be on top of your game, know your script, be off book, and not wait, have us wait around till you finally get it right.
Yep. Yep.
Come on.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
Step up your game, people.
Right.
Advice from Susan Sherman, everyone. Step up your game.
Yes.
Okay?
Yes.
Now, Susan, there are a lot of series actors in Chicago, as we discussed. Would you suggest that series actors stay away from doing extra work, or is it okay?
Oh, never do extra work. Mm-hmm. Never.
What if you're whatever you do,
I really don't know if it's politically correct to do this, but all I can say is if you have in mind to do a union role, co-star, guest star on one of the TV shows, it's best to stay away from extra work, because if ever you're seen, you will never be considered for a speaking role.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So not a good idea. Make better use of your time.
Okay.
Yes.
Yep. Now, when should an actor join the union? Would you?
Well, it's not a choice. You have to qualify.
Oh.
Well, assuming that they do qualify, and they're SAG eligible, they've accrued the amount of points and things. Do you suggest that actors who are SAG eligible go ahead and join the union off the bat, or is that more on a case by case basis?
Well, I would be nothing without my SAG franchise, so I am pro SAG after mm-hmm. all the way, because I would be nothing without them.
Right.
And
so,
what about exclusive and non-exclusive?
It's not a situation like a lot of the other agents are. It's like, hello, how are you? You want to go steady?
Right.
The first time they walk into the agency, they're asking them to go exclusive.
Right.
I would like to get to know someone before I go steady.
Right.
Yes. I mean, it's very important to cultivate a relationship mm-hmm. and see how the relationship evolves. And I'll be honest with you, most of our actors ask us to go exclusive.
Gotcha.
So they said, we like working with you more than anyone else. Can we go exclusive? I said, well, why don't you come in and we'll discuss it? And that's the way to do it.
Yeah.
You know, I don't like a lot of high pressure.
Right.
And like I said, their relationship has to evolve.
Right.
To get to that point where we both feel that it would be a good idea moving forward for their career and for us as a company.
Gotcha. And, you know, you allude to a really important point that even though you joked, like going steady, but really it is a very intimate relationship between an actor and their agent. And it's important to cultivate that personal relationship, because a lot of actors mm-hmm. think that, oh, I booked an agent, now I'm going to be sent
out
on audition.
I'm set.
You know, as Ed always says when he meets with prospective new talent, can't promise you the moon, can't promise you the stars, but if you work hard, we'll do our best to get you out there.
Right.
You know, we can't get you booked, but we can get you the audition.
Right.
Yes.
Exactly.
So it's a two-way street.
Yeah.
Well, I heard actors asking, like, when can I go and register with an agent? And then, you know, is there a specific time, like, when they can get an agent?
Well, they have to be ready.
Ready.
They have to be ready. They have to know what they are interested in doing. They have to have the pictures. They have to have a lot of times the training depending on what they're interested in, like training here, it's so important.
Absolutely.
We had an actor, to make a long story short, take from another acting school. And I think he studied there for 2-3 years. They're no longer in existence. And he came to us and I gave him copy to read, commercial copy. Mm-hmm. He couldn't do it. Mm. And then I sent him to an acting school and it was a complete 180. He booked 2 nationals in 1 week and lived off his residuals for a year.
Wow.
Well, they have to be ready.
They have to be ready.
Yeah, absolutely.
You have to have the confidence, the training, the materials, you know, the pictures, and you don't have to pay a fortune for anything anymore. The resources are available out there, mm-hmm. and if you're determined, you can get there and get an agent and start getting out there auditioning and then eventually booking.
Yeah, gotcha. Getting an experience first.
Yep. Yes.
Like, at least with student films and...
Oh, it's so important to do independent films. That's how you're going to get your clips initially.
Mm-hmm. Yep. Yep. Mm-hmm. Well, folks, we want to thank Susan Sherman so much for stopping by tonight and giving us such great information and advice. And just really thank you for coming.
Oh, my pleasure. It's been fun.
We're so glad to have you here today.
Yeah. Oh, it was great. I enjoyed it as well.
Really, really great meeting you. All right, folks, we're going to take a quick break. And when we come back, we're going to take a look at our new segment inside the Chicago Actors Studio. And I have quite the guest for you this evening, which is going to be our artistic director, Edward Dennis Fogel. So stick around. Don't go anywhere. Studio. We are so thrilled to be speaking with our artistic director of the Chicago Actors Studio, Edward Dennis Fogel, here joining us this evening. And Ed, I do want to pick it up. We actually have these really cool photos of you that I came across. Can you explain this first photo here?
Well, when you're showing it on the screen right now.
I am showing it on the screen right now. Yeah.
Actually, to be honest with you, at one time I was very ashamed of that photo. I was really embarrassed by it. Mm. But today I'm not, okay? I raise it up because it shows, if you look at the photo, you'll see that it shows me with the ringworm and, you know, the tattered clothes and even the pants that don't go all the way down or something like that, you know, and dusty and everything. And that was a classroom picture. Mm-hmm. Right, and I used to think, geez, I'm embarrassed to see it. But now, knowing where I am today, I look at that as really being an inspiration.
Right.
So, yeah. And the other one.
Yeah, that we got another one here that kind of shows your evolution, if you will.
Yeah, well, no, not really. I look a little crazy there or something with the hair or something, you know. My sense of humor, which I think the sense of humor kind of like got me through a lot of part of my adolescent years or something. You know.
Yeah, absolutely.
So, and thanks for showing them.
Well, hey, my pleasure. We just got to do a little throwback, you know?
Yeah. I'm usually, I don't know why I'm feeling a little mellow today because maybe it's this wine.
It might be the wine. From
did you just, yeah. something you put in it or something? Or something to, to taper
me. You'll have to ask your mother about that.
taper me down.
Yeah. Now, you've been at the Chicago Actors Studio for many years, and you started off as a student under Ted List, who's the original founder of the Actors Studio.
That's true.
Yeah.
It was amazing how I came to, by the way, just to throw this in as quick as yesterday was Ted List's birthday.
Yeah, that's right. Yeah, that is right.
And April 5th. The amazing part of it is that Ted List's widow, Mary Beth, mm-hmm. she actually is one of our teachers now. at the school.
Oh. Right.
And we went out to have dinner and everything. She says, just tell us his birthday today. He said, wow.
Yeah. You know?
Or something. But yeah, I got to TED through Shirley Hamilton. I decided to get into the acting arena after being on the road so many years. And so I figured, all I'm going to do, I'm going to go up to an agent, you know, and
get signed up.
And yeah, sign up, you know. And everything's going to be hunky-dory. Just sign up. So I went up this elevator. And there was this real tall lady and everything, and I, with my sense of humor, because, you know, I like to joke around with people.
Yes, you do.
Perfect strangers, you know, I'll joke around with them. And I said, I'm going up to see this big time agent, Shirley Hamilton, you know. I said, and I go, whoop-de-doo, I say it like that. And she just shakes her head and everything. So she goes one way off the elevator, I go the other way. And so I walk in, and I said, I'm here to see Shirley Hamilton. And I was like, making fun of Shirley Hamilton in the elevator.
Just on the elevator, yeah.
And so I didn't even meet her, I was making fun out of her, you know. But I was making, I don't know, it was nerves or whatever. So I walk in, I said, I'm here to see Shirley Hamilton. I get this big high, you know, counter. And they said, well, do you have an appointment? I said, no, what do I need an appointment for? Do I have an appointment? They said, well, you need an appointment, you know, to see her. So I said, okay. So I started to walk out, and then a girl called me back. She said, Shirley will see you. Okay, all right. So
really?
I said, well,
wow.
It's about time.
Wow.
You know,
without the appointment.
So I walk in there, and there she is, the woman on the elevator, with Shirley Hamilton. You know?
I remember her. She was a nice lady.
Yeah. So then she told me, she said that you got to go get some training. So I said, what ain't training? I said, okay. She gives me this. To go see Ted Liss, and I said, okay, I'll go there for 8 weeks, and I'll be out of there, and I'll be a star from that point, okay? And that'll be it. So 8 weeks turned into 5.5 years.
Wow. Wow. Yeah. Wow. That's great. That.
Wonderful.
Because I really, really got into it. Mm-hmm. You know? Matter of fact, I studied there 5 days a week. Most people just went one day a week or something. But they had, like, just like we have here, the same concept. We have beginning, middle, and advanced level. So it didn't make any difference if I was in beginning, intermediate, or advanced. I was, even if I was in the advanced level, I was still auditing
the
beginning classes. Mm-hmm. There were still all kinds of things to learn.
You're such a talented actor. You really
yes,
are.
You just say that because it's true.
No. That is a talented actor. No.
Also real humble.
Yeah. Yes. So,
and you know how to bring smiles on people's faces.
Well, that's
wonderful. Yeah.
Now, so you did, like you said, you studied really, really hard at acting, and you really soaked it up. Do you have?
Yeah, I didn't just study with him. I also studied with with a lot of other, other actors, Michael Shercliff from New York. Went to New York and studied with Michael Shercliff.
He has a book called Audition, doesn't he?
Yeah, he has like the 12 guideposts.
I started to read his book. It's pretty amazing. Cool. That book has all the questions that an actor might have, like when do you get an agent, or, you know, different questions that people ask in class.
Sure.
Yeah.
I also studied with Gary Sherman, who did Poltergeist, you know, and everything. I studied with him, and I studied with people from the Royal Academy of Dramatic Arts as well. Mm-hmm.
Did you do that in the States or overseas?
What's that?
Did you study that over here in the States?
Well,
or overseas?
Here and over there, and then it came here and went there. It was a lot of fun. It was
phenomenal.
All together, different ball game.
Yeah. You know, so a lot of different styles.
Yeah. Jeffrey Connors, studied with him from the Royal Academy.
Do you have a particular style that is your go-to, or the one that you, I would say, I guess, identify the most with as an actor?
Well, same thing as we train at the Chicago Actors Studio is the method.
Stanislavski
system. But we also have Meisner. Mm-hmm. And Susan was asking me earlier during the break, what was the difference between Meisner and Stanislavski. Almost every system, no matter who it is somewhat of a modification of the method.
Right. Mm-hmm.
Okay. There are the difference, though, between Meisner and Stanislavski is Meisner does not believe in other words, recalling things that from your past life to use that because he feels that there's a potential danger to get psychotic about you. In other words, leaving in the past and everything. And Stanislavski believes in using that.
Being stressed, I guess.
And one of the main focuses of Meisner is in listening.
Right.
Okay, so that's why you can sit there for 8 months or a year and just repeat things back and forth to listen how something is thrown at you.
Right.
Stanislavski goes into the method as far as emotional recall, animal exercises, endowment, you know.
Right.
All the actions that stimulate feelings, all those things. It's a little more intense.
Right.
I think Meisner kind of like teaches you to be you in your way.
Right. And captures your essence.
Just to be you.
Right.
So you're using you. Now, Stanislavski says you're always using different parts of you to create what the dynamics of a certain character that you're playing.
Yeah.
Okay, so there's a difference there as well.
Absolutely. Now, we had the pleasure this evening.
How am I doing, by the way?
You know, actually, you're doing all right.
You're doing good.
I feel like you've actually been on set before a few times.
Well, I don't know.
He has been.
As I was saying, though, we had the pleasure of some beautiful guests with us tonight.
And what, are you closing this out?
No, not at all. I'm not trying to get rid of you, actually. I just want to give our viewers at home a peek at what to expect on future episodes.
Oh, I was just going to say that.
Yeah, just what to expect on future episodes, because we're not always going to have such beautiful ladies around, at least not every single episode.
Oh, you probably will.
Right, yeah. Oh, yeah.
Right away.
We might be stuck with just Ed a few times. Okay. So I do want to give our viewers a chance to get to know them and what to expect, but also what we're going to be doing on this segment for them to
what we're going to do with the show. I think it's important it's a product of the Chicago Actors Studio. And Mason is one of the producers. And it's important to note that we're doing this show for you, for all you viewers out there that are in the arts, so you have some sort of a support, a structure that you can, somewhere you can go to, you can ask questions and get answers. And
yes.
Kind of
again, a phenomenal contribution. Yes. On your part.
Yeah. Absolutely.
Yeah, we do want to, we're actually going to set up a feed and also through our emails as well that you can send in your questions for us and we will address them right here on Inside the Chicago Actors Studio. So all of our actors out there, all of our talented people along the Chicagoland area, just as we were saying earlier, to step up your game. This is a great opportunity for you to do
it
just
is.
That. You can tune in, get some information, get some insight, and then actually go apply it to your careers. And hopefully be a guest on our show.
What a valuable resource.
Yes,
yeah.
Absolutely.
Yeah.
Oh, tell them how we're trying to trick them into watching the show.
For
their own good.
For your own good.
For their own good, okay?
For your own good. We do have a few tricks up our sleeves. We actually have quite a bit of awesome raffles that we're going to be throwing your way. So just for tuning in, you have the opportunity to win awesome stuff, like a photo sign, you have the opportunity to win awesome stuff like a signed framed photo of me that you can keep for eons. We also have, I saw that.
Oh, his face.
We do also have.
That's one of the prizes.
That's one of the prizes. It sure is.
Well, listen, they can actually get a date with me for it.
Well, and we want them to tune in, not run away. Okay. We have merchandise like t-shirts, mugs, also $1,000 gift cards towards groceries or food. Chain restaurants, as well as vacations to Hawaii, Puerto Rico, Disney World. So tons and tons of awesome things coming your way. And be sure to send us in your information. We've sent out a few videos, and we have all of our information up on our website to
email us or go ahead and leave us a comment, like, and subscribe to our channel. That'll give you the opportunity to win those awesome, awesome prizes.
Can we go ahead? I mean, this is one of our, you know, first episodes. This is the first episode of Inside the Actors.
Yeah, and we're really.
I would like to see some way if we can take the camera, like, for instance, camera three showing the girls and guys that are actually in the background working.
Yeah.
You know, these are our students of ours. At the same time, they're so dedicated to, you know, to this show and the concept.
Idea.
Is it possible Jonathan could, like, like we can point it to just the each other? To
yeah,
the
if we can just pan real quick.
She's pimping out her hair.
Yeah, just pan it out.
Wonderful.
And actually, there's
Jennifer.
Wait.
You look beautiful.
Yeah. And Tracy, come on out here, Tracy.
Come on out, Tracy.
We want to get Tracy. Come on. Tracy does all our graphic designs and stuff. And our stage manager. Come on out, Joe. I think it's extremely important.
Woo! Nina.
Stage manager, Sarah.
How about one of our teachers? Is Rich Alpert out there?
Rich is out.
Come on, yeah, Rich.
Come on, step out.
Okay, while Rich is coming up, let's get Larry.
Larry
over there on the camera.
Camera and sound engineer.
Okay, we'll point towards Larry.
Larry,
let's get Larry.
Yeah. And we have Jonathan in the back.
Oh, Jonathan, holy jeez, how are we going to get
the
Jonathan?
The anchor is in the back.
We'll show
We're going to have a picture. A picture of Jonathan.
We'll show a picture on the screen.
Well, he's a big star
now. How about Sarah?
So.
Sarah,
come on up.
Everybody knows Jonathan already.
Yeah. Sarah, our talent liaison. And I really, my right
come on,
hand.
Come on out here so we
I
get you on camera.
Anything
there
without
you go.
Sarah. I appreciate you so much. And honestly, this isn't even our whole crew. A lot of our crew members, this is actually an unusual shoot day for us. So a lot of our crew members had some commitments they couldn't get out of. But our entire crew and cast here are just phenomenal, exceptional people. And I love you all so much.
We want you to tune in.
Yeah, I want you to tune in because you'll not only get to know this guy a bit more, but we're going to be showcasing and getting to know our wonderful cast and crew.
And they can send in their questions and then we'll answer them online.
Yeah, like I mentioned, you can go ahead and we'll throw the email up. It's latenightchicago@chicagoactorsstudio.net. And you can go ahead and email us all the questions you'd like addressed. Also for the raffle, again, send us your... Let's go ahead and actually take that back. It's latenight@chicagoactorsstudio.net is our email address.
We're going to use some more of those oops.
Yeah.
The red oops.
latenight@chicagoactorsstudio.net. And send us your questions. And again, you can send us in your name, address, and phone number for the raffle drawings. Actually, Shenna's going to be one of our beautiful raffle girls, along with Roberta.
Yeah.
And Rachel, which we didn't actually. Rachel, come on out.
We did not
get Rachel. There's Rachel on camera too. She's always on camera ready too for some reason.
Yeah. It's such a beautiful compliment of souls that are involved with this show. I all angels. I can't say enough. You know. Love for all of you guys, seriously.
Yeah, likewise. Yes. It really is an honor to do this. So, and it's a good time. It's a
Thank
lot of fun.
You.
And it's not just the wine speaking.
Right.
Being
yeah,
100%.
It is Ed speaking. I know Ed. And we,
oh,
Ed
let's top it off then. Why not?
Yeah.
You need a little more?
Oh, lovely.
Need a little bit more.
Just a tiny bit.
It's all right.
Just a tiny bit.
Wonderful.
All right. This is a celebratory episode.
I have.
Yeah.
Thank you. I'm good.
The big launch.
It is a lot of fun. Yeah. A lot of fun here at Chicago Actors Studio.
What's she saying there?
I love you.
Oh, they want me to remind you.
Wait, could you bring that closer to him on camera? Good.
Remind viewers about sending something funny for Mason to do on camera. Oh, jeez. That's right.
Yeah. Kind of leaves it wide open.
Yes.
Also, we're going to have
no
a segment where you can send in something you would like me to do for this week's show. So, just to give you an idea.
A challenge,
or if you want me to dance to a particular song.
There you go. That sounds fun.
I can moonwalk really, really well, actually.
Ooh.
Oh, we need to see that.
I've seen that.
Yeah, you've seen my moonwalk. I can also make really realistic chicken noises.
Do a chicken noise. Come on.
Right now, Jonathan, just watch out. I might blow your eardrums out.
How did you learn to do that?
Actually, it's a funny story.
Wait till he does it first.
Okay. Yeah.
You might not want to know.
I actually used to get bullied a lot in school, and I...
You?
Yeah.
Really?
You're such a big, hunky guy.
I know.
He knows.
I was always a non-violent guy, though. I never really partook in bullying or took in any of that machismo, and people used to call me chicken. One day it just kind of came out of me, and I just started clucking like a chicken, and they really threw him off. I thought I was psychotic, or that I maybe need to see the school nurse.
They were scared of me.
Then they kind of stopped. They got real scared real quick. But they just called me chicken, and I'd go, and I would even get the head moving.
Honestly, for comedy.
I really want to do like cartoon voiceovers.
Look at him over the applause.
Nice.
We do
those.
Look at the applause. Like, yeah.
Yeah. So if you guys want to hear more chicken noises, I'd be thrilled to do it for you. I could cluck all day, to be honest. Or just send in, if you want, just whatever you want me to do within reason, and I'll... I'll consider it, or they'll just throw it at me and I'll have to do it. So. Jonathan's having too much fun. So be sure to also send in your suggestions. Also send in your suggestions for us, or for me rather, to for what you would like me to do within that week's show. I'll be sure to get that on the segment. And I do want to thank my beautiful guests. Roberta,
absolutely.
Susan,
thank you, our guests,
Edward,
too.
Dennis. Yeah. Thank you guys so much for stopping in today.
Enjoyed a lot.
We're
all the best and much success.
Yeah. Yeah. Really, really a great time.
Absolutely.
Good night, everybody.
Good night.
Hello, YouTube! Thanks for watching! We've got some great new segments coming out over the next few months, so make sure you hit that subscribe button! Then like and share this video, and leave a comment! If you really love us and want cool stuff like early access to new episodes and exclusive behind-the-scenes videos, become a Patreon supporter! Just click the link in the description! We'll see you next time!